In the previous video, we showed how to construct DataFrame objects in Pandas using a nested list or dictionary. A more common scenario is when we need to read existing data outside of our code directly from a file. Today we're going to look into how to read CSV files using Pandas. Just a heads up, some of you may already be familiar with the built-in CSV module, which allows reading of CSV files. That works great for quick, one-off situations, but when you need further data analysis done, it makes sense to utilize Pandas. We can get started with our readcsv.py Python file with our import statement. The directory where our code is contained is our current working directory, which contains a list of presidents of the United States. We'll construct our data frame, which we'll call US presidents by using readcsv and passing in the path of our file. Because we know that our data includes column headers, Pandas will automatically recognize the first row as headers, but it's a better practice to explicitly set the header parameter to 0, so Pandas knows to use the first row, i.e. row 0, for column names rather than data. But what if our CSV file doesn't include any column names? To assign headers, we will give the names parameter a list of header names, which corresponds to our column information. Or, if the CSV file does include headers, but we want to override the CSV header information and assign our own headers, in that case we'll declare the names parameter and assign header to 0 to override the CSV header information. When it comes to using the data from the CSV file, we'll want to use the correct data types so we can use appropriate methods for sorting and analysis. Sometimes Pandas needs a little extra help in determining what data type to use. For example, in order to sort properly by inauguration dates, we'd want to treat them as datetime objects. We can do that by simply setting the parameter parseDates with a list containing our inauguration date column. We can check if the data type has changed by checking the first record of the inauguration date column. Sometimes problems may arise due to missing data. If the CSV has an empty field, Pandas can auto-detect missing values. But if there's a placeholder such as NA for missing values, we need to help Pandas detect them. We can do that by giving NA values, which stands for non-available values, a list of strings that are used in place of missing values. Let's check it out by injecting a full stop as a placeholder for missing values. As we can see, it creates an anomaly and changes our data type from timestamp to string. But if we include the placeholder in our NA values list, we can avoid this problem.